Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. is confident his newly appointed Armed Forces Chief can help boost the country's defense capabilities amid ongoing geopolitical tensions. Philippine Army Chief Romeo Bronner was appointed Wednesday as the next AFP Chief of Staff. The AFP welcomes Bronner's appointment, saying he has proven his sterling leadership and excellent performance in the field. Bronner has been in the military for 34 years, holding key posts. He will replace General Andres Centino, who will now serve as presidential advisor on the West Philippine Sea. The Philippine Defense Chief is keen on knowing the details of former President Rodrigo Duterte's meeting with Chinese leader Xi Jinping. Secretary Gilberto Teodoro Jr. held off from saying if the meeting was a cause for concern. He says that judgment will be made once they know what transpired during the talk. A governance expert, meanwhile, believes Duterte's visit was rife with meaning and shows Beijing's concern over closer Philippine military ties to the U.S.
The visit of President Duterte, while it was not official, was a very convenient way to signal to the Philippines and to Bongbong Marcos that China is concerned. And even while Duterte is no longer president with much less power and influence, still we cannot also deny the fact that he can, through various ways, at the very least, introduce some rethinking, if that is possible. No? It's not a politically innocent visit. It is a form of persuasive diplomacy.
Asia is also grappling with bad weather. At least 10 are dead in India following a landslide triggered by nonstop rains. Rescue workers continue to search for survivors in the disaster site in Maharashtra's Raigad district. Reports say about 100 people are feared to be trapped under the mud. The slopes soaked by overnight rains gave way as residents slept. Authorities say multiple landslides also occurred in the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Flash floods, landslides, and accidents caused by heavy rains have killed more than 100 people in India since the onset of the monsoon season on June 1st.
The Metro Manila Development Authority consults motorcycle hailing firms on how to prevent riders from seeking shelter from the rain under bridges and flyovers. Our correspondent, Andrea Taguines, is now on the line with that story. Andy?
That's right, Denise. The MMDA sought the help of motorcycle taxi firms to address the rising number of riders taking shelter under bridges in Metro Manila during heavy downpours. And right then and there, during their meeting with the MMDA, Grab, Angkas, and Joyride also expressed readiness to help the agency by conducting massive retrainings of their riders to remind them to follow traffic rules. And if need be, Angkas Head of Operations David Medrana said, they can even suspend or dismiss repeat offenders. MMDA Chairman Romando Artes welcomed this response, emphasizing how important it is that these motorcycle taxi firms cooperate with them, since they do not have enough manpower to monitor every overpass, bridge, and flyover in Metro Manila. Artes said that since the no-contact apprehension policy is currently stalled, they will just use their CCTV cameras to identify erring riders, send their plate numbers to the ride-hailing firm they are working for so that the company can sanction them themselves. As for Joyride Vice President Jericho Meneses, he suggested having a specific time limit for riders to seek shelter. But Chairman Artes thumbed that suggestion down, saying it would be too much work for their already undermanned traffic enforcers to time each violator. But he did assure stakeholders that they will be reasonable in terms of apprehension, adding that riders will be given sufficient time to wear their raincoats and for their passengers to also wear their raincoats. Meanwhile, MMDA officials also met with leading oil firms this afternoon to discuss the setup of tents in their gasoline stations as alternative and temporary shelters for riders during heavy rains. But after the meeting, Artes said that these oil firms were a bit hesitant since this might disrupt their operations, especially if a lot of riders troop to their gas stations. The MMDA says they will have to devise a plan to prevent that from happening ahead of the August 1 enforcement of this no taking shelter under bridges rule. Violators will be fined 500 pesos. Meanwhile, some motorcycle riders we talked to said the MMDA should not begin apprehension until these tents are a done deal or until they provide more lay-by areas for them, especially along highways. Denise?
Thanks, Andy.